Hey, what's up everyone? This time around, we're going to be running Assetto Corsa. We are going to be running the Porsche 911 Carrera RSR 3.0 at Silverstone GP. Now when I think of Porsche, this is basically the model I personally think of. Alright, let's see what goes. And we are off. Every now and then I see this brake bias information pop up on the screen. I'm not really sure if I could take it off. If any of you guys know how to switch that off, would you please leave it in the comments, because I would like to switch that off if it's possible. This is the new Porsche pack that came out recently for Assetto Corsa. This is the first pack. There's a second one coming out, I believe, on the 22nd of this month, November. And the next one will be somewhere to the end of December. I decided to pre-purchase the other two packs, which basically means I purchased all three packs at once for a discounted price on Steam. So whenever they come out, I'll be able to get it as an update. This car wants to drift. It's easy to induce a drift on this car. Like right here. Of course we know that going sideways isn't the fastest way around the track, right? But sometimes you can't help it with this car. It's just so much fun to drive. There's someone next to me. Easy. I don't know what I did there. I went in there way too hot. And I took a bad line. Anyway, it wasn't too bad. There it is again. 63.5% brakes bias. I'd love to switch that off. It's the 4% brake bias now. The thing is, this brake bias seem to be changing ever so often. I don't know if it's a setting that I have. That I have one probably. In fact, I think that's probably it. Maybe it's just certain that I have one that's causing that. When I think of a classic Porsche, this is the model I think of. The 911 Carrera. This body style is so cool. You see? But it's not too hot. Try not to hit him. I said I was number one sim driver in the world, you know. I'm just having some fun. As Sean Poole once said a couple years ago on Inside Sim Racing, there are sim racers and there are sim drivers. I consider myself a sim driver. Just because I don't take the racing aspect of this, like, as in competitions and stuff, I don't really take it very seriously. So I don't have time to practice. But it doesn't mean that when I want to have a lot of fun, you know, I still want the best equipment that I can afford. I still want it as realistic as I could get it. Which kind of brings me to VR. I was actually thinking recently about purchasing one of the Oculus Rift CV1, but something is telling me to hold off for the second version. I'm waiting for the CV2 to come out, and I'm hoping that the have better resolution on the second model. Right now, that's all I'm waiting for. Wait a minute, we're in first place. Sometimes when you're talking like this and trying to concentrate on driving, and it's not the easiest thing to do. Let's see. That was not good. I guess the next best thing, if you can't afford VR, or maybe you just don't want to buy VR, maybe not yet, I guess the next best thing might be to probably use the head tracking software from Natural Point. Actually, I have one of it, but I don't really use it that much for some reason. I used to use it a lot more when I had a single screen. But now that I use triple screens, I mean, I could look out my door, I could look out the door on both sides, so I don't really tend to use it as much anymore. As I mentioned, for me, I used to get a great deal of tearing sometimes, according to the, you know, according to which game I'm running. Oh, that's a lot to stay. Okay, let's try and make a fast lap. Okay, this is the last lap. I don't really see anyone in sight, which makes me wonder just what settings I have this game on. I thought I had the AI on 100%, but I'm kind of doubting it. Very much though that this AI is on 100%. I have to look into it. Wait a minute. I thought that was the last lap. I actually didn't realize that the race was still going on. I thought that was the last lap. I guess I'm wrong. Well, I guess this one is the last lap. Oh, too hot. I wish they would fix this. I just don't like the idea just of a race finishing like that. It finishes so abruptly, if that's a word. I don't like it. I would rather be able to drive around the track and come back into the pit myself. Anyway, well, guys and girls, well, you know, I'm like I said before, I'm so busy with work right now that it's so hard for me to put out videos. But when I started this channel, I kind of wanted, you know, for just for myself, I wanted to be able to put out at least one video a week, which, as far as my calculations would mean, I should have 48 videos by the end of the year. Well, right now, as far as I'm concerned, I'm down by two. But we'll get there. Anyway, till the next one, see you guys soon. Take care.
On the right, or on your right, clear on the right, go left.
nuts. Let me set up some competition.
Alright.